on the door that came from some forgotten world. Mindful of his lava craze, the rattle-flapping microbeams ignored it into my amazement, rolled to Ferris in 12 days. This is the words of a virus, stranded from orbit on the ocean of Osiris. I'm told all she can for every member of her plan. Expanding exponentially by suffering this virus. So we stand on the train, admiring the time. As the lights of the city drew near, and we drank a little wine. They were blurring green outer space in between, with a depth and a foam unclear, and we saw it up ahead. The green lantern lit up on the chance in the rust that it covered up the bridge. From the banks of the river to the bend of the valley of the stream to the place we live.
contagious in moments like these. Consume me and strengthen my will to appease. The passion that sparked me one terrible night. Shocked and persuaded my soul to ignite. Shocked and persuaded my soul to ignite. Shocked and persuaded my soul to ignite. Shocking my soul to a flame.
was coming, calling the sunset. I couldn't believe how much I tried yesterday to get away and hitchhiked to the beach. I saw Satan on the beach trying to catch a ray. He wasn't quite the speed of light, and the squirming coil, it got away.
Burn the whale, find a scuff and go to jail. Force of
got a lot of nice tones.
passing through the corridor, I came upon an aging man leaning against the wall in knightly armor. He was on his way to see the king. Through the streets of Prussia talking, as he tried to crush a bug that stood underneath his blue heel. He said there was a place where we should go. So he led me through the forest, to the edge of the lagoon, by which we wandered till we reached a lovely spring. The night grew very quiet as we stood there. He lifted up his visor, and he turned to me, and we began to sing. Set a cup for the land of darkness, set a cup for the land of doom, set a cup for the land of gaming, for the land of the big baboon. But I'll never end up going back there, couldn't even try, cause I come from the land of lizards, and the lizards they have died, and the lizards they have died, and the lizards they have died, and the lizards they have
I'm Papa.
this means things took place here. You think about this. Here's the, we've got this little town with all these innocent people that come out every Christmas and hold hands in a circle and sing Christmas carols and all that. And then there's this really mean guy that lives up on the hill with his dog. Of course, I'm talking about this kind of sledding animal. Anyway, in this particular town, on this particular Christmas season, a strange thing happened. There was a day, the man was up there with his evil dog, and he was coming down on this big sled to bring all his presents to the innocent people. And he was coming down the hill into the suburbs of this beautiful little town. Looking forward to the air. Anyway, in one of these houses in this little town, there was a boy named Jimmy, who you all heard about. And on this particular day, Jimmy was sitting in his house, as he did on many afternoons, petting his beautiful little cat, poster not bag. Yes. And he's sitting around this day, he's petting his cat, poster not bag, unaware of the man on top of the hill coming down with an evil dog. I am skipping the beginning of the story because I assume that most of you have heard it before. For those of you who don't know what's going on at the beginning of the story, there's a lot of preliminary stuff, but just ask the person next to you. There's this guy with his dog, and he comes in. Because I really want to get to the meat of the story here.
Meat!
The meat.
Meat
issue! Anxiously rushing through the preliminaries to get to the meat of the story. Yes, there he is with his dog, Poster Nutbag, and he goes to Jimmy, goes to open the door, and lets Poster Nutbag out the door. Dog, as he does in every story coming down the hill, dog, cat, coming towards each other, getting to a fight. Now we are at the beat of the story. Picture the dog, picture the cat fighting. The incredible thing about this particular day is that the fight between the cat and the dog was so ferocious that they began spinning around each other, clawing and biting and hissing and drooling and tearing at each other's flesh. So viciously that they began to spin in a circle, and they actually spun so fast that they created a tornado. So the dog and the cat are fighting, spinning, creating a tornado. The tornado is spinning faster and faster, sucking all of the suburban houses in with the Christmas presents, the trees all suffocating, more and more vicious. And the tornado begins to spin so fast and so viciously that it actually begins to dig a hole in the ground. And the evil man from up on the hill, and they're in hell, and they're down there in hell, and they're looking around, and Jimmy looks around, and he smells the horrible, evil, rotting flesh smell of hell, and the burning brimstone, and he feels the heat, the horrible heat of hell burning on his skin. He's terrified. He looks around, he doesn't know what he's going to do. He looks forward, and he sees the horrible face of hell, the uber demon coming towards him. Terror is filling his head. The uber demon comes towards him, and he opens his mouth, and the horrible sound of hell comes out of his mouth, and Jimmy hears the horrible sound of hell.
Thank you. drawn, you cannot fight him. He feels himself start to melt into the lava below him. And he sees the dog melt, he sees Harpoon melt, he sees Poster Nutbag melt, and they all melt and begin to drip into the hot lava below.
Thank you.